saw our trailer last night announcing that Undisputed will be launched on gaming consoles October 11th, 2024. We couldn't be more excited. My name is Todd Grisham. I'm the voice of the game, as well as the vice president of global affairs. I signed almost all the fighters, along with my great partner, Jose De La Cruz from Grand Enterprises. Here beside me, to my left, is the CEO and the creative director of Steel City Interactive, man that made all this possible, Ash Habib. To the far left, Igor Sklimas, one of the great managers in the world today, and he's also in the video game. And of course, the man of the hour, who is fighting for the undisputed heavyweight championship of the world tomorrow. A big hand, everybody, for Alexander Usyk! I think he needs a microphone. My first question is going to go to him. There you go, Alexander. First of all, what are you more excited about, the fight tomorrow or being here today to talk about the video game?
Play it's good, but tomorrow big fight. First, it's of course fight. My focus. Tomorrow.
What was it like for you to be scanned in the video game, to see yourself in the game? What was that experience like for you?
Listen. It was my dream, because when I was little, yes, I watched game and boxing called Tyson, Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali, Arturo Gatti, oh, it's great. Maybe, but future, I too be a player. Now it's real, it's true. If you hard work, it's true.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
What do your kids? What do your kids think about it? Are they excited their dad's in a game?
My kids play game sometime, boxing. No play. Because I only by, you know, like
just a
cancer, yeah. More time play my children. I not wanna do reclam this play. play judo, because my children go to sport judo, boxing, football.
So they're waiting for the console, Xbox?
Yes.
All right. Well, that'll be coming in October. Ash, let's turn it to you now. First of all, a big week for you. What was yesterday like, having the big announcement that we're launching October 11th?
Oh, it was amazing. You know, we've been working at this for 4.5 years and all working towards that moment. And just seeing the response, the whole boxing world coming together for the game. It was, yeah, just an honor, really, being around everybody and seeing all the hard work and effort that the studio, people in the studio have put in, you know, with the help of the people around us.
When Ash was building the game, obviously to make the game look amazing, took a lot of technical work, a lot of hard work, but getting the fighters in the game was kind of some milestones that we celebrated together. I remember the day that we let you know that we signed Alexander Usyk. Do you remember that day? What was your reaction?
Absolutely. There's been quite a few pinch me moments throughout development, and the calls from you and Jose about this is, you know, we've got this person, and I remember specifically when you told me about Alexander, I was like, no, come on, you guys, you always pull my leg. Just be honest with me. You know, have we got Alexander? And yeah, it's just a great feeling to be able to, you know, as a boxing fan, as a gamer, to have like legends of the sport, you know, being represented in a game. When we got Alexander, it was really.
Obviously, we had to go through Igas. Igas, when you heard about a boxing game coming onto the market, I know you were a little skeptical because you get calls every day about things, but why was this opportunity one that you decided to go forward with?
Well, when I had a phone call from Jose, who's my partner now, I knew Jose only from when he was managing Linares, and we met on the opposite side when he was fighting Linares, fighting Vasily Lomachenko.
that he will be, he goes like, I'm the manager of the United States. Like, what the hell do I have to do with you? You know? He goes like, well, we're building this video game, and they said, well, cool, but what's going on? And he goes like, we would like to sign Alexander Usyk and Vasily Lomachenko for the game. And I kind of like thought a little bit, that would be unfair to the rest of my fighters. And at that time I had like maybe a 20 fighters under my wing. And I said, the only way we can make a deal, I can talk to Alexander and to Lomachenko to sign him, but every single one has to go. And he called me later, and that was actually a funny story. He called me to sign the fighters for the game, and a week later I talked him to become my partner in the restaurant. So I got his having $1.5 million from him in the restaurant business.
Shook him down.
That's how we got the undisputed.
How's that restaurant doing, by the way?
By the way, grand opening end of June.
All right, well, good luck with that. What's so cool about the video game for the first time ever, you can get a manager in the game. You'd be one that you could select. You pick it for your fighter. They can help give you fights. The realism in this game is off the charts. As a manager, what do you look for when you're looking for a fighter and helping a fighter? What makes a good manager in your opinion?
In the game or in the real life?
In the game and real life. And we merge them together.
Well, you know, first of all, I just don't look to the fighter as a fighter. I look as a person. I look what kind of a man he is, and is he a pleasant to work with? That's my main thing, and I help him. Like, you know, if I become a manager, so he becomes like my son, like my brother, you know. We work together. Probably I'm only one manager in this world where I don't have no signed contract. All of my fighters, I work with a handshake. Even Alexander can say, you know, we never sign any kind of a contract.
Wow. Well, in the game, you have to sign a contract.
So unfortunately.
Alexander, when you got scanned in the game and you put on the suit to do your punches, what were some of the things that you felt they had to get right about your style and about your character?
Все, что выделяет, все, что я делаю в ринге, все это и должно быть в игре и чуть-чуть больше.
Everything what I do in the ring, it has to be in the game, and maybe a little bit more.
And Ash, it would have been much easier for you to make like an arcade version of a boxing game, make it more fun and explosive and things like that. But realism was very important to you. Why was it of the utmost importance for you to make this as real as possible?
Again, I think as a boxing fan, for me, when we started out making the game, the realism was just as important as getting the legends in the game as well. So it wasn't the easy route, for sure, but I don't think we've taken the easy route in any decision we've made. But I think if you want to have something special, then you know you can't take shortcuts. And for me, the realism was another way for us to kind of do justice to the sport as well. So yeah, as fun as you know some arcade style games are, that's not what we wanted to make.
And one of the things also in this game, you can fight with today's fighters against the old fighters. So I'll ask you this, Usyk, what's your dream fight? Of all the fighters that have ever lived that are in the video game, who would you like to match up against in a fantasy matchup in the video game?
Pleasure of boxing is Muhammad Ali.
And what do you think would happen if that fight did go down?
I think Muhammad win, but but I will do more what I have.
Got it. Ash, what's your favorite matchup in the game? If you were to put two fighters on the stage in a fantasy matchup.
Honestly, it was Usyk versus Fury.
You don't have to play the game right now. The game you see tomorrow, right?
Exactly. So yeah, I mean, there's so many to pick from, you know. But you know, Ali and Usyk would be incredible. Just the two styles, it wouldn't be a boring fight, that's for sure.
And as far as the fight on Saturday, if you win, and obviously
when you win,
and you win the rematch, what else is there for you to do? Are you still be inspired to continue forward? Do you have other goals in the sport, or would you say I've climbed Mount Everest and I'm done?
I'm gonna continue boxing because I love boxing. This is for sport. Give me more opportunity. This is sport. Give me a lot of my. My friends, it's not like friends, it's like brother. Because boxing is like part of my life. I'm gonna continue boxing. I love boxing.
And if there's people out there that aren't great boxers, would you say, hey, stay at home and play the video game? You can get really good at that instead?
Definitely.
All right, one final question to you, Ash, before we opened it up for some questions. Just kind of your vision for the future of this game. How successful do you really think it's going to be, and what do you have in store for us going forward?
I think the game, you know, people have been waiting for like 12, 13 years, right, for a boxing game. And then hopefully people can see that we try to do justice to the sport. And yeah, I'm very hopeful, excited. We've got the, I guess as far as new things coming along with the announcement we've made, is the Kingdom Arena is going to feature an Undisputed as well. So that's something we're really, really excited about. So yeah, just overjoyed with how everything's gone. But I just want to say quickly, like I've met so many fighters around the world. People have been in the game, people aren't in the game. Everyone's been amazing, but Alexander's just a real special person, you know. Yeah, there are just very few people on the planet like him, boxing aside. So it's just an absolute honor and pleasure to be around people like Alexander. And, you know, Igis, Jose, they've supported me throughout this entire development process. And yeah, I think just being around people like that is really kind of motivated me and inspired me, and the studio as well, because there's not many development studios that have the opportunity and the chance to work with people like we have here. So yeah, just want to say thank you to you guys.
And I heard you guys are gonna be signing as celebrities, like a movie actors and other ones. So I can't explain that to let you know right now, because it's kind of like, but we got a very big role for Alexander in the Hollywood blockbuster. We're going after this fight, we're going to shoot the movie. He's going to be playing one of the main roles with a big, huge actors. And hopefully, when you're going to be signing celebrities, movie actors, you're going to re-sign Alexander again.
Wait, can you act? Are you ready to be an actor as well? Have you been taking acting classes?
Listen, it's second my dream.
Really?
When I little girl, you know, I wanna go to study at university, movie, yeah. But my family don't have money, but pay. This is study. I go to sport. University, because I win the local championship Ukraine in junior, my coach, oh, we have opportunity to go to more boxing. It's senior, you know, when I junior, it's senior, maybe Olympic Games. I say, oh, wow, Olympic Games. Yeah, you can. I say, Yeah, what I can? You can win. Really? Okay, maybe try, maybe try. But now it's real. Well, it's giving me boxing. First time it's giving me God, Jesus. But second, because I work every day, it's boxing.
Are you going to be a fighter in the movie, I assume? Are you going to be a drug dealer? What are you going to be? Boss.
Maybe a hooligan boss. Big. Big.
Big guns?
Yeah, big guns.
All right, guys, we're going to open up for a couple questions. Alexander only has a few more minutes to be here. I'm going to pass the mic over here to the lovely Carly in charge of our PR. She made everything possible. Big round of applause for Carly this week.
We have room for just a couple of questions, so please put your hands up and we'll pick a random.
Just one quick question. Who would you say is the greatest boxer of all time?
For me, it's Muhammad Ali.
Alexander, 5 years ago in Chicago after your first heavyweight fight, I was sitting in front of you like you're sitting right now, and I said, fighting like that, you're not going to beat the best fighters in the world. Right now, in 24 hours, you're going to go for number four. I'm not saying you listen to me changing anything, but my question is completely different. Did you ever not believe in yourself? Even if people were telling you, you cannot do that because reason one, two, three, doesn't matter. Ever in your life, did you not believe in yourself?
A lot of people told all my boxing career. It's not possible, it's not possible, it's not possible. Not believe me. Listen, my mama sometimes told me, son, maybe you stop? I say, mama, it's only start, no stop. A lot of people told me, hey, boxing, you and boxing, no. Please go to work, go to study. I believe every time. My father told me a lot of year ago, my father told me, son, you can. I think, what I can? I say, Papa, tell me please, what I can. You can more. If you hard work, you can win, you can live, you can will be happy. A lot of people told me, oh, you are not heavyweight. Okay, I'm not heavyweight. For what? I'm here. And tomorrow will be a big fight. It's me with my Tyson Fury. It's undisputed heavyweight. I not believe people. I believe Jesus. I believe my friend. I believe my wife. People. A lot of speak. People not believe. Yes. What?
Thank you.
So it answers the question. He's always believed in himself.
Yeah. One last question.
Hi, Alexander. Welcome to Riyadh. My name is Rahman Amro. I'm from Middle East. So I would like to ask you about gaming question. Do you think video games like this game or any sports game inspire the next generation for sports?
We must give our children not only games, sport and games, because games very good mind, boredom in the mind. Yeah, a lot of people who on just play, it's bad, because we must do yeah to combine games, sport, and study. Education, it's very important, not only because people who good play but not have education, it's bad, because people take more money, know not how this money work. Education, sport, play is good, and God first, it's God.
A big round of applause for Alexander Usyk. We wish him well. He has to head out, but if you'd like to do some one-on-one interviews, Ash Habib is available, as well as the super lightweight champion of the world, Dalton Smith, is here. I'd be more than happy to answer your questions. Thanks again, everybody, for coming. And once again, big round of applause for Igas, Alexander, and Ash.